डॉक्टर राजेश काजी श्रेष्ठा, चेयरमैन नेपाल चेंबर ऑफ कॉमर्स नेपाल. डॉक्टर राजी काजी श्रेष्ठा's business journey started 4 decades ago with a diploma in commerce. His hard work has been recognized with various medals and token of appreciation by the government of Nepal for his contribution in the business sector of Nepal. He is honored as commercially important person. He also received a honorary degree of Doctor of Philosophy in International Diplomacy by Foreign Policy Research Institution, New Delhi, India on February 2, 2010. He is a former Assistant Minister of Ministry of Industry, Commerce and Supplies of Nepal. He is currently the Honorary Consul of Vietnam in Nepal. Dr. Rajesh Kazi Shrestha is here to address on the topic, how to connect with Nepali food companies. We are privileged to welcome Dr. Rajesh Kazi Shrestha to the summit at Vibrant Tamil Nadu.
Good morning to all. Vadakkam. So why we are here? First of all, I would like to thank the President of the Vibrant Tamil Nadu. And I definitely, Jakasa, very closely we've been having 2-3 opportunity with the Vibrant Gujarat and all the distinguished here. And few, from 2-3 days we were being A&B hall. So when we talk with all, so they said, wow, what Nepal can connect with Tamil Nadu? So that's why I want to say a few things, how we are here. Firstly, I would like to thanks the organizer for a warm hospitality and the delegation from such a large from our country, because we all thought that, so we've been connecting with North India and West Bengal and other, but they thought the Tamil Nadu, yeah, we've been importing few items from Tamil Nadu. So the food item we saw, we heard about the South from Tamil Nadu about that. That's why all have shown interest. That's why we are here. So once again, we thanks for the all the organization giving this opportunity. So not only that, we are very much excited to have a connection with all the food grains and the other item for the technology know-how. First, we thought how we could import, and so then, so like make in India, so we would also like to have with a joint venture with you in Nepal, and we can export to other country. So talking about, everybody knows about Nepal. We are situated with the between China and North and India, in the southeast whole with the India, and the capital is Kathmandu. So the mostly 1/3 part is with the India, and we have a three climate like Himalayan mountain area, Tarai area, and the hills. So we have a 4 type of climate: winter, spring, summer, and autumn. So talking about Nepal Chamber of Commerce, and so before, I would like to say proudly, because I don't know, I was also in that chamber when we have a signed MOU with the Tamil Nadu Chamber of Commerce, maybe 40 years before. But I thought we should have again renewal because of the request. So Nepal Chamber, it was established in 1951. So it is the one of the oldest chamber in Nepal. To enhance the capacity development of private sector to provide a suggestion and trade between the all the industry. So we are very much closely working with the government. And now regarding the yesterday we have signed MOU, definitely it will again renew for us, and there will be the record. I don't know, you have a record on the what we have signed 40 years before. But only we have a record, we don't have other thing also. So how? First, before connecting, I would like to say, Nepal is one of the agro-based country before, not now, we say. Now also, the government have a focus on how we can grow all the agro in Nepal, and instead of importing, we start exporting. Before we export all lentils, rice and everything, now we import everything. So this year, to have a growth with our own, the government have a increased little tax also. So now what I would like to repeat, the same thing. So now the time have come that Nepal is being a, what we can say, a neighboring country as a huge, largest big both country with the neighboring country, India and Nepal. So there are many opportunities there. As a being LDC country, there are another one. So it is not proud to say being a LDC country, least developed country, but there are a good opportunity. Like why I repeat this? So when we talk about the joint venture in Nepal and make in Nepal, so whatever you have a production there manufacturing, so you export to USA or you export to Europe, so you, the importer doesn't have to pay any tax. So that are the opportunity there. And whatever you export to India, about we have a 30% value add to India, so that also we don't have to pay, the importers doesn't have to pay, we have a trade and transit TT with the India. So likewise, we have a 8,030 item which we have signed an agreement with the China. So whatever we import, there are mostly herbal and all the food item and agro base, so that we can export to China, there is no duty. Definitely being a neighbor country with the both country, so there we have a very good opportunity of investing and doing, because I have talked with many here, so I have talked with all the large company. So the mainly the with the herbal and other, so let's have your branding in Nepal after a few years or maybe few months or for the few days, so we can see for joint venture and we can export to many other country. So because it is a good right time also now because of the China and USA trade war, so it is a good opportunity to do a production in Nepal and export to USA because we get the RECS and GSP opportunity. So that is what all the businessmen are looking for. And recently we have the visit with our Prime Minister about a month ago, and the KP Sharma Oli have jointly signed and for with India for the research of agriculture products in Nepal with India, with the supporter of the India. So that is also one of good sign what we see about the agro base. And on very soon, on last of August, we are having a BIMSTEC. So this BIMSTEC will also, because of the all the BIMSTEC countries, it will be representing Nepal. On that also will be focusing on agro and agriculture products. So it will also be very benefited to us. Nepal was agro-based, as I have said. So now we are import-based in many items. But the few years, so we have been now, we after a long time, so there was a very big load shedding. So we have a 16, 17 hours load shedding a day. Now we have a 24 hours. And another, what I would like to request and to know all each other, that we, after the long, long period, so we have a majority and a government, which is a stable government. Hope now this will continue. And we request all for your trade also, for your investment also, it will be the best for to come and look for Nepal. So as an agriculture facility, I have said everything, the KP Oli and the senior province. So we have a 7 province. So just recently, after the change of our constitution, we have a 7 province. All like Jagat Bhai, as a Gujarat, all our province, we give an example of Gujarat and we say, so they are competing each other. So it is the right time to invest to Nepal. So because they are giving a land for a long-term lease also. So it is a good opportunity. So as I said, technology transfer is there. So the main why we are here and why you have invited us also. So the both way. So the main, the lease what we are importing from India to Nepal. So I would like to, because I saw 2-3 where I have discussed with the in the stall. So please watch them and you see. Because though Nepal is a small market, but it is a regular market. And it is a place where if you export to Nepal, you can advertise to the world, because as a tourism country, as all the tourists from the world can see your product in Nepal. So these are what we import all the live animal, about 1,808 million INR, and the meat and edible meat official about 32 million, and the fish products and preparation of the meat of a fish about 827 million rupees, Indian rupees. A dairy product about 2,199, and the products of the animal original about 56 million in INR. So we import the, all the live trees and all the plants also about 56 million point. And the mostly we import all the fruits and nuts about 11,445 million. The coffee, tea, and the mat and the spices is what we import about 1,991 million. This cereal where we have many items, so there it's cereal we have covered many, so which is more than 24,948 million of we import from India. So I'm talking only from India. There are other items which we import from the different country also. The mostly our 70% trade is between Nepal to India is our the 70% trade with India. The products of milling industry which we are getting for the, all our milling area is 528 million. The oil and fruits is about 2,090 million. And jumps and the regions are other vegetable snaps, which is around 83 million. And the sugar and confectionery, so 3,004 million. And after seeing 2-3 confectionery, I think it will definitely add on next year data. And cocoa preparation is about 655 million. And the pastries and cookies, just I was waiting and I went there. I have also talked with one confectionery, Hope, the EFIDA. So they have circulated to all their members about Nepal interest. So definitely it will increase next year. But instead of increasing, we hope so we can, when we are here next time for the like agro, we can show. Now there are a few joint venture who have come India. So we want to show that also with your all your support. So the miscellaneous eatable item preparation is around 2,092 million. So the beverage and spirit, so like vinegar and other we import all, though the Dabur have a real juice factory in Nepal, so we export from Nepal to India, but there are many items which we import also from India about the juice and other spirit. The prepared animal feed, so all the feed what for then we import around 77,659 million. The tobacco and the manufactured tobacco about 1,529 million. So how? Connection, the main thing why we are here of connecting. So one connecting what we say with the like this expo, so we participant of this and knowing all about the products of the Tamil Nadu and the, all the South India and definitely the chamber to chamber relation. So likewise, we also have a chamber expo every time on November 4th, November 29th to 3rd. We hope we have talked with 2-3, so you can participate with your delegation also. That will be another to connect with Nepali food item, to Nepal to food item from here. And so we have, as I've said, the third, we are very much closely with the West Bengal, Bihar, and the UP, Uttar Pradesh. Definitely for Tamil Nadu, Uttar Pradesh will be our nearest road. And we are trying to, with the Indian government, how from the long way, like Tamil Nadu and other cities, how we can connect with the rail where we can have a transportation little cheap. So because we were here for 3 days, so we saw like Kathmandu full of temple. And this only the connectivity with the agro, not only that, this is a where connectivity of our religious Hindu also and the Buddhist also I saw. So because Nepal as a being a small country and though we are a very imported a large amount of we are import based, but we prefer that. So if I could show this about the tourism, then I think you will definitely visit Nepal and we can increase our business and hope. So like Bangalore, we have a direct flight. You will have a direct flight from Chennai or Madurai. So then we can have a more business. Like we saw, we were in Meenakshi temple day before yesterday. So we saw it was more than 3,000. And So Nepal, we have a 2-3 cities like Surkhet and other place where the similar temple was built there from long time. Now it is spoiled because some earthquake and this. So when we feel that, we see same from the south like Tamil Nadu. And we talk about Mansarovar, where all the south and they have to come through Nepal. Either they have to go from our Nepal, Nepalganj from nearby Lucknow, Simikot, or you have to go through Lhasa, Kathmandu, Lhasa to Mansarovar. And talking about when we talk, see the all the Shiva's temple, so we are proud that Pashupati, the head, so is in Pashupati, is in Kathmandu. So Muktinath, recently your Prime Minister visited Nepal, he spent more than half day in Muktinath. So we wish, so because not only the connecting with the B2B with the agro, and it is good that if you come to visit Nepal, like we came here, we saw all temple and we feel that, okay, now we should come with family, with my grandpa, all the old days also. That's why I would like to share a few things about Nepal, about tourism. Definitely, in old, there are 14 peaks. So the Mount Everest is in Nepal, and the 8 peaks are in Nepal. Buddha was born in Nepal, but we say the Buddha was born, the whatever he have done, the all the occasions is in Bodh Gaya. So these are the thing where there are UNESCO, 10 UNESCO old heritage site in Nepal. So I don't take more time, I just want to show. So all the Kathmandu, Bhaktapur, Tan. So because I'm taking this opportunity, so about Nepal and connect with, so that all feel to visit Nepal and do business more. So these are our national park and the trekking routes and cultural heritage site of Kathmandu Valley. So we are also, like your culture, we are also very much traditionally cultured. So I thanks, because I'm little in hurry also. So actually I request for the president and the all the organizers, because my presentation was at 3:30, I request early, because my plan, when I'm here, I should go to Rameswaram, Kanyakumari, and other. Within 1.5 day, I have to finish 3 places. So anything, I saw 2-3 gentlemen, which I have requested them to work with, because I'm also in food line. That's why also I was so interested. We have brought so many delegation. So they are here. So because of my presentation, and so they feel willing to do with me as a business also. I request them also. So we are very much willing. I have seen 2-3 product here where we can start immediately. So thank you for inviting me here and with my team. So I thanks from all from our chamber for inviting me here. Thank you very much.